And also the process of going through this vitro fertilization.
Yes, yes.
For the conception of the child was also a challenge for you in life.
We tried 6 years to have a baby. Mm-hmm. That love could not stop there. Mm-hmm. It had to grow. Mm-hmm. After 6 years of trying together to have a child, I have decided to kind of make me understand that, Céline, don't be greedy. I was talking to me, mm-hmm. Don't be greedy. You've had the family, the friends, the career, the success, the money, the support, the fans, the tour, the cure. You've had it all. Don't push your luck, girlfriend. Mm-hmm. You want a baby? Life has decided that you had enough. For one person, that's enough. Enough. You know, you can't have it all. Mm-hmm. I have understood and came to peace with that. Was I going to adopt a child? Probably. Mm-hmm. And then it came so fast. And then there was another possibility for me to go and see one of the most extraordinary specialists in New York, Dr. Rosenwax. Mm-hmm. We went, and it worked. Our son is named René Charles, and he's 6 years old.
Do you still recall the moments when the baby was born, how René reacted when he, for the first time, held his son in his arms? What did it mean to him and to you at that moment?
First, about 3.5 months pregnant, we wanted to know if it was a boy or a girl, because my husband was so scared to die. If I die, at least I'll know. We went to see the doctor. And then when the doctor said, it's a boy, René has one girl before and two boys. And I said, why are you crying? He said to me, I am so happy that it's a boy. Oh, I said, I'm sure because Anne-Marie is your unique girl and maybe you wanted to keep it this way. Not at all. He said, if something happens to me, I know that your boy will take care of you.
Wow.
And since that moment, that boy was going to make history, was going to be my biggest dream ever.
2002年 Celine 带着她的新专辑《新的一天终于来临》出现在拉斯维加斯的舞台上。就像专辑的名字一样，付出的 Celine 在经历过与病魔的抗争、隐退、生子等种种人生体验后，一种全新的活力和激情再次爆发出来。那一首首以爱为主题的歌曲中，包含着她对爱的深切理解和对生命的一份感激之情。
You have been singing so many songs of love from
and
the very
beginning.
And you won't stop. And you know, maybe some of the songs can be dedicated to the things that happened to your life at that period of time.
Absolutely.
Can you relate them? Like, can you raise a few examples?
Love for me, like you say, is the most powerful thing. You can break barriers, you can lift mountains. But love is the most painful thing in different ways. Love happy like giving birth to a child, finding the man that you can be partners for the rest of your life. Different types of love. Love of a mom and family and the fans. But also love hurts as, for example, I lost my dad 3 years ago. I loved my dad so dearly. It was very painful when he left, but it's very amazing because he lives with me every day. There is no longer any barriers. We live together. I was very fortunate that my dad saw my wedding. He met my husband. He saw my son. He saw my show.
Now here we come into the segment with very quick questions and answers.
Okay.
From my audience.
Okay.
Okay. The first one. Do you want to have more children?
I would love to have more children. Once the show here is over, the tour is over, I'm gonna hope and pray for more children.
Do you have any plan to come to China for a concert?
Yay! I'm coming to China, actually in April.
2008?
In 2008, April, and the shows will be Beijing, Shanghai,
Guangzhou.
And Guangzhou. Looking forward to, and it's very exciting because I'm gonna be going to China and touring the world and show the world to our son.
What has kept you so strong in front of all the turbulences in life to go through those tough moments?
I think I have to owe this to my parents, the way I grew up, a foundation. The base is the most important thing. My parents gave us, our family, good values. You know, the discipline and the will and the dream and the good values, you know, like the discipline, but as well like so much love, compassion for the others, and being aware, you know. So we had good values in life as we were children.
What if someday you stop singing?
I have my foundation, I have my life. You know, a lot of people think that it's like, life for me is like a ladder. You go one step at a time, you go up, 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 and that's what people think, that I'm going up. But they don't know I've been coming down. That's what they don't know. I started right there. At the top of my gig, I started right there, my head in the cloud, looking down. You know, it was like just so beautiful. I was dreaming all the time. People were there at the bottom of that ladder to help me. I was feeling very strong. Every step of the way, I'm coming down, I'm grounded. I'm gonna be 40 years old soon, and I've never felt that strong, so grounded. I know the best is yet to come. I am right here.
Celine 周围的很多朋友呢，都是早年和她从蒙特利尔一起打拼出来的，在过去的20多年当中一直相伴左右，这让我更深地了解她说的那句话：人们都以为她在顺着阶梯一步一步地往上走，而实际上呢，她却在寻找自己的根基，友谊、爱情、家庭、孩子，这些才是她生命中最宝贵的东西。好，感谢你收看这一次的杨澜访谈录，我们下周见。
Wow!